we disagreed with a lot of what they were doing in that game. It started off with them, like, Fnatic trying to force things a little bit too much, and then there were some very clear errors. Like, there's typically going to be, like, really outstanding errors in the late game just because there's one little mistake can cost you everything at that point, but Fnatic definitely did not look very clean in their execution and communication. There were issues where, like, team would go in and the rest of the players wouldn't follow or vice versa.
We're here now into game two, the draft underway. Fnatic opening with the classic Phoenix Void combination. Ben, how do you rate this kind of opening pick? Is it still the way to go for teams?
I think it's fine for Fnatic. I think they were more comfortable in the late game, but they were like, oh wow, we need to teamfight them. But they didn't have the teamfight heroes. So if they want to play more teamfight, they should draft more teamfight heroes. So that makes sense to me.
And Ben, how would you rate the not so classic first pick Rubick opening from Alliance?
That's fine. I think Alliance, there's not really any like key heroes from them that you need to take away. Like, it's not like, oh man, we need a first ban Beastmaster for versus them or they're going to own us. They're not that type of team. So it's like, okay, they can pick whatever they want.
Yeah, I think Rubick is one of those heroes that is not very much picked up in the meta right now, but he's just always kind of, he's okay. You know?
Yes. He's always been relevant.
Yeah, either, like, there are two tiers for Rubick. It's either he's okay or he's good.
Yeah.
And it just depends on which patch.
There's never been a point where it's been like a team's pick Rubick and it's like, this is not the meta or the patch to play in. Yeah, for sure. It's always been a very staple pick. The second pick for Alliance this time, they are going to go with the strength of the Lifestealer. I mean, already, I guess, the Void, you have got ways to control the Lifestealer, but at the same time, pretty good against the Phoenix in terms of taking down the egg.
Very good.
Yeah.
One of the best heroes alongside, like, Juggernaut. Fast attack speed, yep. Slark, plus magic immunity.
Lifestealer, Juggernaut, and Meepo. Yeah. The best. Troll. Sorry,
troll.
I forgot Troll.
Yeah, Troll.
Don't forget about Troll in 6.88.
Yeah, Troll actually, 6.88, we may actually see him picked up once or twice.
Still seems like 6.87 to me, though.
Yeah, that's right. Not much of a change at all. Brew, actually going to get banned out this game. Obviously, S4's performance on it last, but it's pretty impressive. I mean, he was incredibly disruptive in the fights, and I guess that's exactly
really
why you pick up
cyclones.
The Brew. Yeah, the Cyclones were there every time, multiple times in the same fight.
Mm-hmm.
It was very strong.
So what's the replacement hero for S4 at that point? You want probably
Puck,
another...
Do we see a Puck? Yeah.
Yeah. Do you think that in the hands of S4, Puck is worth the pick? Because at the Manila Major, it was not worth the...
I think it's very good versus Faceless Void and Phoenix. You want a long duration silence to kill Void. I also think Storm Spirit warrants some discussion. Yeah. Especially with his Lifestealer.
Okay.
They're both carriers for Lifestealer.
Did he get buffed in 6.8? He got buffed a little bit, right?
He did. You tweeted about it to Blitz, didn't you, Cap?
Yeah.
What was it? Was it the Remnant slow
minor.
Or something? I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Overload got buffed, right?
Overload.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Overload damaged, increased by a little bit. Okay. 10 at all levels, and Overload AoE increased.
10 seconds remaining. I think...
That's pretty good.
5 seconds. I think Puck is most likely the pickup here. Now, Earth Spirit picked up that really limits Storm Spirit in the mid lane for sure.
Yep.
You're very exposed hero in the first 5 levels.
So. Now we're back to Puck.
Or Quap.
Or DK. DK's
DK.
Also nice and tanky. Yeah. Just get up in there, tank all the ultimates. No problem. They don't have that much magic damage right now. I guess maybe some from Magnetize, but DK has such a large HP pool. Remaining. And a long duration stun versus Faceless Void. Why not?
Well, we have, of course, seen S4 to be one of the players that has, like, the Leshrac still recently.
Oh,
is there any reason to pick up a Lesh this game?
I don't think so.
No, they when Leshrac was picked up by Liquid, for example, it was matchup based.
S4. Sometimes they first phase it.
They do.
Yeah, they do.
He does love his Lesh.
But I would personally say that Alliance should not go down their full Yolo route like that. And just pick.
I think it's
Lesh
a good last pick.
Yeah, I think it's a really strong like 4 or 5 pickup.
They could also go for Death Prophet. Death Prophet's also pretty decent. Long duration silence.
But yeah, I mean, again, in this game, you have to consider like the mid matchup is always going to be difficult because of the Earth Spirit roaming.
Death Prophet's good versus that though.
Death Prophetess, yes.
Bristleback and Invoker coming out again. Bristleback, pretty nice set against Fnatic's lineup. Doesn't care too much about being chronoed or the kind of the silences of the spirit. And of course, again, extra bit of an attack speed to bring down that egg with the Warpath passive. Cottle's going to be the second support here for Alliance. So a bit of the Ake Cottle coming into play this game.
You don't get any attack speed with the Warpath.
It's the damage, isn't it?
Damage and movement. That's okay.
Catching me out there.
The old.
I had to double check myself.
Instant double quills for Bristleback off of the newer.
Yes.
Chakra
yeah,
magic.
With the new chakra. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, a few back, but yeah, the more recent build. Yeah.
They've run this a lot.
Oh, the Storm Spirit ban as well. Look at that. They were worried.
Wow.
They were worried about the storm.
You demand, Ben.
I tried to bring it back to relevance. Fnatic were like, no.
Man, Storm Spirit being banned. Damn. What an age we live in.
It's coming back in 6.88.
It absolutely has, apparently.
You know, it's funny. I was actually thinking about whether Fnatic would go back for their Tusa. 5 seconds remaining. Before they picked the Invoker. Mm. Good thing they didn't, huh? Because then the Keeper of Light was the opposing pick from... it was actually banned out by Alliance in 3-4. I didn't even notice that.
It's good versus Lifestealer.
Yeah. I think if it wasn't banned away, Fnatic would have picked it up.
And it's the Fnatic specialty.
So now, we still go back to the same conversation, which is Puck.
And what do they go for?
Puck?
I mean, I think they would, because I don't know if you remember, there was a game, I can't remember what it was in, but they did do the Storm Cottle thing, where they just forever kind of hold the base,
yeah.
Where he just
it's
boosts
really
him with a chakra,
good.
Recools yeah. him, and he just zips down a lane, and bam, he's back. It's, you know, it's something.
They like came online like just like 2 or 3.
And they, I mean, they lost the game.
Yeah.
They did lose the game.
If that game had been sped up like by 5 minutes, it was like Alliance could have taken that with that strategy actually.
I'll see what they go for now. I've taken the time to think about this one, so maybe indeed, yeah, the storm was what they're wanting.
Quat may be better because she's a BKB carrier.
Okay,
because BKB's really good versus Fnatic's lineup.
It's gonna be the S4 bat.
Nice.
Yeah, I like that. They needed some extra lockdown actually. They needed like a really solid disabler versus the Faceless Voids.
You can also get the double napalm with the chakra.
Wins the match.
So
sure,
good.
Instant double sack, yeah.
Which is not good. I was kidding.
No.
It's something.
It wins the matchup against
that extra stack, Ben, could get you the kill. 5 seconds. Here we go, Fnatic now. They're looking for Mooshies here, aren't they? What would you pick up against a Lifestealer?
It's more so what they want, Safelane versus Cottle Bristle. That's going to survive. Yeah. Slark, I think, might be decent. They don't really have that much lockdown for him. What else is good?
Yeah, I guess, yeah, Silver Edge game could be nice. Silver Edge carrier.
Yeah.
That certainly could
what
be
what else is
table.
Good?
Drow Ranger. Ranger good?
Drow Ranger.
Very dubious.
It makes it so the Invoker
there's a
matchup.
Lot of in-your-face heroes.
And there's also only 3 ranged.
Yeah. The Invoker matchup goes better now.
Yeah.
Because Batrider can win that.
That's bold.
Not anymore.
Yeah, Lifestealer, Bristleback, Batrider just all up in your face.
Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah.
And I also think
they've drafted into a corner.
They can defend against a push very easily with Keeper, Bristle, and Bat. These heroes are like really good at extending the game, at least making sure it goes past 20, and then Drow Ranger, not so useful. I must say I like Alliance's draft a lot more.
But then again, to be fair, going into game one, we did also like Fnatic's draft a lot more.
Did you see their play, Owen?
Yeah, did you?
Did you see their play, Owen?
We'll go by that.
If somehow Alliance end up losing this
if they
game
play
against Fnatic.
Like Fnatic did in game one, maybe.
Yeah.
But this time around, Fnatic, as we've seen, a little bit shaky so far at the beginning of the day, and now with the draft, as you said, I mean, you're saying Cap, in a bit of a corner here, they've got to go for a very kind of specific play style and specific hit specific timing.
Yeah, I didn't like Slark, terribly. But I think that was actually maybe their best other pick.
TB would have been okay, I think.
TB.
Very, very high armor versus the Bristle.
Yeah.
He has Sunder. They have like no way to stop his Sunder unless they lasso him. There's no save, but I don't know. It still would have been okay. This is just dubious. We'll see.
I mean, at least... The one thing you could say about this kind of strategy, like a Drow Ranger strategy, you're playing to win at the very least. Like, you're drafting yourselves. You're not just drafting like, oh, we have the disadvantage in the drafts. Let's just pick up the okay Slark pickup. Here, you actually have a strategy that can end the game by 25 minutes because they have so much team fight. they can actually win their laning phase against Bristleback and
why not just
Cuddle,
all in then? Why not
different?
Just go like Pugna or something?
No,
then.
I think. Oh well. Okay, I guess that is.
You said you want to play to win, dude.
I was like, Ben, how can you get more all in than a draw Ranger strat?
Pugna, safe lane Lycan, I think is also pretty good at ending the game early.
I mean, just at the last pick though. At just the last pick, where they, I think that the last pick is where they got to the point where they were like, oh man, we're screwed on our.
Nothing's
lanes.
More all in than safe lane Pugna.
That is true. No, I agree with you, Ben. You did get me there. I was like, what's more all in than a draw Ranger pick? Well, the yeah, a Pugna carry.
Oh, is this going to be a Quas Vex Invoker?
Why? They have a draw Ranger.
I think that's why.
Oh, yeah, I guess. I guess it depends. I always think of Exort pushes, but.
Exort pushes, yeah. But it's really good with the team fight with the Chrono into EMP. That kind of destroys your lineup, even though they have Chakra to kind of deal with that. I don't know. We'll see. Alacrity, I think, is also slightly better if you're Quas Vex, which is really good with the Drought Aura.
Yeah, with the attack speed you're getting.
And Orchid versus Lifestealer, really good. If he's Quas Vex. Let's see it. Let's see at level 2. What are you going mid 1?
I mean,
he did not pick up
right?
a Magic Stick. Wow.
You don't get Quas against a Batrider level 1 unless you're going Quas Vex.
That's true. Where's his stick?
Kinda like pointless.
Wow.
Yeah, where is his stick?
I don't know. Mid one is an unusual player though. Like, I think he's what 8K, but his mid matchup was like not that great. You rarely see 8Ks lose their lane that badly.
Yeah.
And he was really good in the team fight. Usually it's the other way around. They're like really good at winning their lane, but not that great at transitioning. But kind of opposite for mid one. Very interesting for him, and it will be the Wex. And
the roll. Did DJ not drop
didn't
a
put
stone?
I don't think he did.
Oh, he missed it. Yeah.
He missed the stone that he dropped. Okay.
DJ's a really good Earth Spirit, so that's an awkward mistake to make.
Yeah.
Meanwhile,
maybe he's on tilt from last game.
Yeah, probably. It's like, goddamn team.
He's like, maybe if I don't play well, my teammates will carry me.
Yo, look what Ake's doing. He's crafted himself this little nook where he's able to blast both camps.
Oh. That's the AUI style.
Nice. Yeah. We haven't seen this in a while. But he'll probably stop doing this. I think once he hits like level 3 and help out Emerald Bulldog.
Nah, you can keep farming for your scepter, dude. 15-minute AFK jungle, baby.
I mean, if you have like 2 tanky Lifestealer and Bristleback, the heal from the Caudal Blast is actually going to be
look
really
at that
good.
Triple stack. Dang.
We got high, just zipping down there onto S4, trying to get the rune away from him. But it's not going to be the case. S4's able to secure it. Meanwhile, the lanes, I mean, for the Drow, yeah, he's having a great time. But Bordo's
Ohio's like, what's going on here?
He smells something fishy.
But
I mean, how do you stop? Do you stop the Colt doing it, or do you just have to let Ake do this if you are Fnatic?
You crush your lanes, or you invade his jungle. You have to do one or the other. Or you jungle yourself. That's also okay.
They got the roll on mid.
Let's see if they can follow through on this one there. I've got the Colt snap down with the EMP. They might just get this one. Going as well, no. I haven't got the damage. S4, he'll live through. He's got a full bottle as well. So unsuccessful gank there, unfortunately for the side of Fnatic and for DJ Top going in. Open wounds, just harassing Ohio back. That is still going to come in and give him a right bit of a punch here. Ohio not too scared himself, and we'll just play around it. I mean, where are we most likely to see the first death this game? Do you feel?
Mid.
Mid.
Just because of her spirit.
Yeah.
Earth Spirit things. That's
wherever Earth Spirit is.
Yeah. Because Bristleback is going Iron Talon jungling now.
Okay, Bulldog.
So he's not going to be in lane against a Draw Ranger. That would be the other hero that's really in danger. Ohio is unlikely to die just because they don't have a whole lot of burst damage against him.
I think DJ should be. They have the Observer Ward, so they have to know what's going on here. But they're just still not interested. At least, at the very least, I think you leech his XP or disrupt the stacking.
I think they should. I think they should have brought 3-4-3. They should have gone for a smoke gank and rotated on mid and made sure that gank was successful on S4 and then rotate into the jungle.
That's true. I like that a lot more.
Yeah, because you need to crush lanes, as Ben said.
Yeah.
So the best way to do that is rotate both.
He's already level 4.
And there's nothing really our Phoenix needs to like. He's pulling, but it's still like ineffective. For you to just like single pull as a support when you could be doing so much more. When you're facing up against a 4 position, it's farming.
That's true. He is very farmed. He does have a lot of magic resistant creeps in that, and a satyr, so I don't think he can take that. But that's what Batrider is for.
Yeah. They could actually, they have 2 different
ways. Or Bristle, yeah. But Bristle would just do Ancients. You want to maximize your farm.
Yeah, I agree.
I mean, we can see again, DJ's coming. He's looking for a bit of action, but of course, this is all spotted out on the sidelines by this ward, so unlikely that S4 will be caught out by this one. Does need to be careful. Again, anyway, he's got full vision on 343 as well. So S4 knows.
Cold Snap plus Sunray is really powerful. Oh god, but he missed!
Yeah, misses the initial roll, and S4 trying to play around. He's got four stacks onto mid one. In fact, S4 trying to go in a little bit aggressive. Was hoping that EGM could get in close enough for a telekinesis. Wasn't going to be the case, so Fnatic, not able to find anything, but at the least, Alliance themselves did also have three heroes there and were unable to turn it around and finally kill him. In fact, S4 could be in trouble. He hangs around a little bit too long. This time, DJ will connect, and S4, that's going to be your first blood for mid one. Getting caught out there by the fact that DJ was more than ready to come back in on the mid lane. S4 just, he was not expecting that one at all.
DJ finally gets his successful initiation after failing so many times.
343 checking out the stacks. He will see it, but doesn't have any vision or any wards. But he knows that they're stacking.
And as well, looking around.
Okay, DJ just got hit by a... He casted a Fade Bolt, and DJ was sitting up the hill, and he got hit by the Fade Bolt. And then he still rolled, so he knows they have vision up there. Awkward.
Ward for ward. The ward that Alliance just placed. I like this one to help out Bulldog so he can play a bit more far forward. Because if he gets hit by the Earth Spirit and the Drone Ranger slows, he's kind of done for, most likely. So he can play forward now in this matchup against the Drone while the Earth Spirit's roaming around. But it did get scattered out by the ward placed earlier by Fnatic.
See, at the moment, Ake just kind of set up base here at the bottom and just constantly firing in the light, making it very, very hard for Mushi to find anything at the moment in this lane. He was having a great start as well, Mushi, 40 for 17. But this is going to put a bit of a holder onto him, and Lotus should be able to take over in terms of the CS game at this point.
Just a bit too late for Midwan to take all this. He might be able to get the kill, though, solo on S4.
Let's see if he can play his way around this one. Indeed, out of mana, out of luck. You've got the bottle charge, but again, in comes the tornado.
Quas Wex.
It's Quas doing Crow. It every Aura. Single time. It seems to be working very well against this bat in this matchup.
Yeah, it's pretty good. There's nothing really like the tornado is just so good at resetting the stacks if he can't even play aggressively.
Oh, okay. Does he get himself out of this one? No, he doesn't. DJ on point this time. It's an easy kick for the man as he stuns him. And Fnatic now finding a third. So as you said, they do need to secure the laning stage. And 7 minutes in, it's certainly feeling to go that way in terms of kills. But at the same time, Ake did find a lot initially on the call. He is level 5. But I guess Alliance, they can't really afford to give up kills like they are at this stage.
I liked what they were doing at the start, where they just parked the Keeper in the jungle. But they deflected the gank in mid, and then they moved the Coddle to the bottom lane. He was level 4 at 4 minutes. Now he's level 5, and it's been 3 minutes since. And he stacked one time for S4, but then S4 died. They need to protect their jungle a little bit better if they want to play that aggressively. They were also able to park up that ward.
Again, in the mid lane, EGN tries to come for some quick and easy levels. There won't be that quick and easy, as mid one now on a killing spree. I mean, as you said, Ben, he's an interesting player, mid one. And we're certainly seeing why he is indeed that 8k level that he is. 42 for 12, 3 kills on the man thanks to the rotations of the support. Now, this is setting up to be a very good Invoker game.
Look at his damage, plus 51. He's like Exort levels of damage.
And the sad part is they can't really do much to stop this bleeding because they really need the Blink Dagger on the Batrider first. Unless S4, I wasn't sure how that was possibly going to work, but.
The sickest flame break known to man?
I guess so.
A bit of a whiff there. It looks like Fnatic just want to continue to put pressure on the mid lane. DJ and 343 in position. Ake is the only one hanging around at the moment. EGM's making his way back there. Does want to try and find the solo XP to get that level 6. 343. Eyes on towards EGM coming in between the towers. A scan as well just to make sure nothing else is happening around it. Looks like they won't be able to get anything as we see. Alliance, they're playing very, very safe now around this mid lane. EGM and Ake making sure that there's no chance of them giving up their lives. And in fact, they're going to jump in onto an illusion. S4 back, causing a little bit of a kerfuffle here for Fnatic. Nonetheless, they're going to start to move out and actually look towards the mid lane. They'll get the kickstun onto EGM. And EGM, puts a fairy fire, will survive for the time being. But the urn ticking the man down. They'll get the last one to DJ. They can kill the Earth Spirit in return. But Ake looks to pay off his life as well. So it's a 2-for-1 trade again for Fnatic. A mid one. 5-0-0. The game just keeps getting better for this Invoker.
And Drow Ranger damage. Enabling Midwan to just go crazy here before the Alliance Blink Dagger plus Infest combo is ready to go. That's when the game really changes, but S4 still has not been able to complete this, despite the stacks they've done. Oh, is he dead? He's actually dead. What? Why does he... What? Is this the build? When you're 1v1 versus Lifestealer, you don't max out Time Walk?
That's the bottom lane. Mushi's in trouble, guys. Bulldog and S4 on the case of the man. And in fact, they'll find themselves a second. Bulldog, you got the stacks building up here. DJ will roll in. They're looking to take down the Bristle. They will get it in return. But that last 3 minutes of play certainly favoring back into Alliance's hands. As you said, finding the kill up top, two down bottom, including Mushi, and only losing Bulldog off the back of it on his Bristleback.
So we agree, not build.
Not the build.
Not the build.
If you're scared of dying at all, which clearly he should be.
Yeah, open wounds is a really strong slow, and you've got phase boots.
This build is good if you're jungling.
Yeah, but he should have known that he was going to be left 1v1 for a lot of time. Okay, we're just getting chunked down.
Okay, I guess I'll just chill here for 15 seconds.
15 seconds. He can't approach the creep wave if Lotus there with mana.
So mid one already with his Midas. That's pretty darn good farm from him.
It really is going excellently for the man on the mid lane. And as well for Mushi, despite that one death, he still is up there. We'll see on the net worth what it's looking like in the S. 5.8 for mid one on his Invoker. Lotus still just ahead of Mushi on the lifesteal. He's been given a lot of space on this top lane. But the pressure's there on the bottom, and Fnatic, they'll find themselves a tower. I guess at this point, is this where you start to move Mushi around the map and just power down the lanes? What's the plan with the drow?
This is where you don't die to the Batrider smoke gank.
I'll see what
is happening. Yeah.
If you're a Fnatic, you just kind of sit back. I think the best play is actually to move Ohio in a position where he's able to counter the lasso. So, like, move your two supports behind mid.
Oh, now they see the blink. They ping it out. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
It's not good for Alliance. Are they going to smoke up onto the ward? It looks like they're waiting for it.
Are they going to fall for it?
I mean, they should know. Anytime there's a four position.
And look at this mid lane. They're jumping straight in onto EGM. Fortification will come out. I mean, EGM, he's going to go down, trying to do the control back onto DJ to turn it around. There's a sideline Chronosphere onto two from Ohio. They're moving in for more. Cold snap. EMP's down on the ground next to S4, and in comes the big bird. They'll take another Fnatic with a double kill on Mushi. And now it's just the retreat for Loda and Ake trying to get themselves out of here. The Earnest Shadow starting to tick down on the Keeper of the Light. Mid one looking to get himself in position to finish off this DJ. A good kick from him would do it. A second earn charge. The kicks off point, Ake continuing to fall down incredibly low. DJ, he's going to roll in, take down the Kotl, a third kill for Fnatic. And looks like he'll get himself out as well.
Wow, DJ is so bold. If Ake had released that half a second earlier, he would have rolled into a wave.
I thought he was just going to go for the silence play. But
if he silences, then he gets hit by the blast.
Hey, great play by Ohio, though. Have to say, him having
that
the wherewithal
corner
to be able to go, like, okay, yeah, EGM's very dead, we got the tower, let's go two, right? And he finds the Chronosphere on the two.
I think it all
heroes
goes back to them losing control of their jungle so early. Like, yeah, having that ward placed down and not countered by Alliance slows down the Batrider Blink Dagger. Mm-hmm. It kind of gave away their blink timing. And here they go with the Invest Bomb.
So they get anything top.
Time to TP out Mushi.
Yeah, you got to get yourself out of there, boy. Oh, they've got a Flame Break, though. Mushi's in trouble. Maybe not. Mid one with a three-man tornado. EMP laid down as well. Mushi, he will still fall. But mid one, looks like he's managed to buy himself the time to get himself out of there. Nonetheless, losing their carry, Fnatic. But keeping mid one alive, and it certainly feels like this Invoker, he's kind of the real carry at this point. This is what a lot of the weight is on for Fnatic. And I would like to just point out as well, I just noticed at the top, I mean, unless I'm going crazy, I don't think Fnatic won the first game, did they? As the score's indicating at the top.
No, they did not.
The score at the top is wrong, guys and girls. Alliance did win first game.
I like how you had to check with us. Oh, it's like, am I crazy?
It's fine on stream. Oh, yes, it is. We've covered it up. On stream doesn't even need to worry about that. So we're good. We're just confusing ourselves. But again, okay, S4 losing his life. I mean, this Invoke, 505. It's, I mean, when's the Invoker show going to stop, and who on Alliance is going to stop this man?
When one Invest Bomb.
They can't do this, right?
I mean, they steal the stacks.
They cannot do this. Come on.
Here we go.
Come on, Fnatic.
That Drow aura, though.
You're going to be taking a long time to go through this one by one. They're bringing the Drow Ranger over.
It's still going to be really slow, and they can just die to an Infest Bomb. They need a reveal on Alliance, though, if they want to kill the Invoker.
Yeah.
I'm surprised they don't have a dust on the Batrider.
And they somehow managed to get the scan. They're like, guys, they're in our stack!
That is going to take forever.
Are they
Fnatic, if they lose this fight...
I mean, they've got the Chrono.
This is going to be so silly.
Here we go.
It's going to
How
be
much can they get of this? Oh, they might even DJ. He's found EGM on the sidelines. Great control. The sun rays out. This man in a lot of trouble here. But at the same time, Alliance look for the reinitiative. The Chrono comes out, but they've already lost Mushi on the Drow Ranger. Ohio look for the lockdown on Test 4. He's out of mana. They'll pop the supernova. Can Alliance take it out? Ake trying to do his best with the high ground. Loader comes in as well. They'll take down the Phoenix. And now Fnatic, they're the ones on the retreat. Mid one and DJ trying to get themselves out. DJ will roll himself away. But as you said, guys, it didn't work out trying to take those ancients.
I can't believe they tried that. I really cannot believe that they tried.
That was so dumb.
They have two golems and...
Mid one's going back for it.
A black dragon. Why?
He's got to recover now. Now they made the mistake of going for the... Uh-oh.
Oh, Bulldog. Hey, this is...
He's got him.
He's got 4 points in the bristleback and stick charges. He's good.
They need to jack them as they're doing the stack.
I mean, they're trying to defend the ancients, boys. Yeah.
Now, mid.
He's giving up now. He's like, all right.
I got it, OD.
Screw these ancients.
What are you? I was sitting here giggling.
You are not giggling.
All right, Ben's just trying to make me look bad, guys.
Come on, Ben.
Keeper needs a scepter. I think.
He's nearly got it, yeah.
Once they take out the stack, I think they'll be equalized in net worth. Even so, I feel like Fnatic, they're losing a lot of the momentum because the Drow Raider has died so many times. Three times is a lot when she had free form at the start. And I think it's going to continue to get worse unless they get a lot of four stabs. They have one up on the Invoker.
Yeah, this is supposed to be like an okay period of time where Drow Ranger, where you only have to worry about the Blink and Fest Bomb combination. But once you start getting like Admiral Bulldog is bold enough to be able to just challenge you constantly, you have maybe a Blink on EGM.
Yeah.
Is another thing you're going to have to worry about. Four staffs and those sort of things. Like, there's just going to be more and more issues for the Drow Ranger as time goes on. So they really needed to keep the pace up on this game, and they're trying to now by going for the tier two and giving up on that ancient stack that was so futile for them to try and challenge earlier.
That was silly. Do you see that stack and you're like, man, we can't let them have this. But that doesn't mean you take it yourself.
Yeah, that means you either challenge them, you get good vision up, and you try and catch them while they're doing it, or if you want to just go like for a really, really safe play, you just push the top lane. Because you know at that point in time, Alliance are going to farm the ancient stack, and you're okay with that because at least you're going to get a tier 2 and take over their jungle at the same time.
I think it's better to take down the T2s on the bottom Radiant's side, bottom though. I think if you take that, then you could actually challenge Alliance, and Alliance, they don't want to do it when Bristle's at half health, because then he can just die, and then the ancients will be low.
Yeah, so. I guess you can just like stall them taking it by pushing bottom and mid.
Yeah, and then you can do it yourself with like Drow controlling the high ground near the secret shop and just plucking away from there. But yeah, the way they did it was just like their positioning was just like ugh. You don't do it.
That
like
was literally something you would see in a pub. It's like, guys, there's ancient stack. Let's do it. One idiot has the idea. The rest of the idiots all follow suit.
Yeah, so it's certainly the way it kind of kicked off as well. Because
we have Vlad's guys. Let's do it.
Vlad's and Drower, you know what I mean?
Yeah, against like a 3,000 HP goal.
Maybe if he was Quazixul. You know.
The sport spirits.
Yeah.
Would have made the difference.
Dude, it's the Granite Golem had like probably 2,500 HP with the dragon armor. That alone would take him like 10 seconds.
Maybe if the Void's Battle Fury was not purely just cosmetic.
There you go.
There we go.
Now you're speaking.
Owen's found.
Yeah. I found the fault.
Or if Mushi already had an axe.
Yeah. Actually, yeah. I mean, are we going to see an axe escape? What's the build for Drows nowadays? No. What would you expect to see Mushi go for?
Almost always Dragonlance. Dragonlance. You can siege towers from outside Radiant's tower range.
Get a Manta dump.
Manta that is...
That's what he's doing. He's got Manta.
Manta is good versus the Batrider.
Yeah, you want some sort of quick interrupt.
After that, it's generally Butterfly or Diffusal for mass agility.
Okay.
But they only have three heroes that can make use of the Drow, or I guess maybe even like two. Because
did you say
really
four staffs in there?
I did not say four staffs. Oh yeah, Hurricane Pike's okay.
Yeah, I think you have to consider four staff and go into the Hurricane Pike just to get yourself distance against the Lifestealer who's instantly on you, and if he's raged up, you can four staff yourself out. And then the Bristleback, who's going to slowly charge his way at you.
And aren't you more worried about the Lasso Death, though?
Yeah, for sure. But what is you build Manta.
Oh, Silver Edge. Silver Edge is the build here.
Okay.
Yeah. I like it a lot versus Bristle, because you can actually kill him in the fight.
AS4, he's got a bomb ticking, jumps in on 3-4-3. Goodbye, Phoenix. But the Chronosphere comes through. Can they turn this one around? Mushi on the sidelines, punching into S4, but S4 keeps himself alive. He's going to be kept alive by the Aghanim's heal from Ake, and now they're going to find themselves even more here by the looks of it. They'll turn towards DJ, take down a second Alliance. doing it there. Huge heals from Aken. EGM, Stolen Tornado isn't going to clip anyone. But Alliance getting it done there with the Infest Bomb.
Oh, what is Ohio doing?
That's twice now that he's seen an Infest Bomb and has somehow missed the Chronosphere on the Lifestealer.
Phoenix still would have died.
He still would have died, but then you wouldn't have had a Lifestealer challenging Draw Ranger immediately.
I think, why are you surprised that Ohio is...
Is it all Listen, he was one of my favorite players from TI3, all right?
Yo, I love his mag. I love some of his other heroes, but sometimes he just has an off day, man.
Or off week. Off month.
Playing around here. Dilates. Backs himself off. Can they do anything to stop this? It doesn't look like it can. No, it's already gone for Alliance.
They have a huge damage issue now, because Invoker can't do all the damage, which he has been doing, but... Now that it's gone to that mid phase where Bristleback has his mech and they have the heal from the Keeper, they need a lot more damage than they have right now. And you saw the Lifestealer go straight onto the Drow Ranger, there goes your aura, there goes most of the damage onto the Invoker. They had a Chronosphere on a hero that already uses ultimate, so they are going to have to play really well from here on out.
And let's not forget the Aghanims on Caudle also ensures that Alliance will have have a huge vision advantage. Because they've got both Batrider and Keeper of the Light. There should be no wards that stand up as soon as they get a gem.
They'd want to try to set up some of it with the Ghost Wall, maybe.
They definitely need a gem.
Fnatic. We've got DGN 343 smoked up. Alliance just cleaning out the Ancients here. They might actually catch out S4 as we see this movement into the jungle. DJ, he's got to hit it off with the start. We get the silence, the stun as well. And yeah, S4 in a lot of trouble by the looks of it. I don't know if there's going to be any kind of backup that can save this man. And indeed they can't. Fnatic. They get themselves the pick off onto the bat. We'll see what they can turn this kill into. Same time though, Lotus picked up the Desolator. He's pretty much hitting the exact timings that he needs to. 21 minutes in, Deso, Armlet, Echo Saber, Phase Boots. This man can chunk for anyone on Fnatic.
If they get the Orchid on the Invoker, I think they can maybe win a team fight. And surprise by killing the Lifestealer before. Actually, he has Armlet and Aegis.
No, he's big. Oh, higher. Yeah, off you go. Mib 1 still kind of keeping things on for the sidelines. They'll just drop the Chrono. Higher looking to set things up. Mib 1 turns around, begins to pound into Ake. They'll take him down. Let's see if they can find anything else. Tornado catches Loda here on the high. They do have Supernova still available. 343, he's got to get himself out. Will be forced away. So we'll just be the kill onto Ake and then the disengage from Fnatic. But they're still in a good shape to try and fight for more.
Alliance are like, why are we fighting during nighttime? Yeah. Even though they have Aegis, they should not be fighting during nighttime. It's just not a great move for them.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if you have the extra life. The right combination of Chronosphere and Egg will guarantee win the fight for Fnatic. So Fnatic can keep on going if they want to and try and go for the bottom tier 2. But I think at this point they just farm up.
Lifestealer needs to be like so far out in front that the supports don't get caught by the ultimates. I think that's more important than... Like what's been happening? Because if Ake weren't up there, then they would have been okay that fight.
Yeah. Do you want Lifestealer out in front, or do you want Bristleback?
Well, Lifestealer is Aegis, so
yeah, I guess so.
I think definitely him. Maybe if it's daytime, I think you can have Bristleback up front. But for nighttime, I think you have Lifestealer up front. If he gets Orchided, then maybe you just force step him away with a Batrider. But they can just play it safe. I think they're like farming very, very well. They can still get up into Drow Ranger's face. They need to kill this Invoker though for that huge chunk of gold. He is beyond godlike.
Yeah, they get that kill. I think Alliance secure like almost a huge advantage in the mid game that Fnatic won't be able to overcome. And then they've got a Draw Ranger strat that naturally runs out of steam.
But what can Min 1 do with this?
DJ rolling him from the sidelines. They found out Ake. Can they bring this man down? They'll get the Magnetize out onto him. See if they can follow control. Lift onto DJ, bringing him back. EGM trying to hold back Fnatic. DJ being chased down here. Load on the back lines, chunking into Mushi. The Tornado. Stoller comes in at the right time and they'll take down the Drow Ranger. Can they find themselves anything else here though? The Chrono comes out from Ohio. DJ's been clipped in as well. They're on the sidelines. They'll actually find themselves a second, an Alliance. They're looking to be in a good shape at the moment. Aegis has been popped from Loda, but he's ready for round 2. Great lasso onto Ohio, making sure he can't time walk himself out. They will lose Ake, but Alliance looking to move in for more. The damage from Loda coming through. Where's your detection, boys? It's not there.
Wow, that would have been like 1,500
kill.
Gold. That, maybe 1,000.
That would have... that if they had detection there.
That was such a bad fight for Fnatic, too. the way it started off, like them trying to make the initiation for DJ and he doesn't get the instant kick while he's rolling. You see really good Earth Spirits, and DJ is supposed to be a really good one too.
Yeah,
they roll in that they kick at the same time as they're rolling. Or do the silence at the same time he's rolling. But he couldn't get the damage fast enough out there. Batrider survives.
Oh, mid one. Look at this, playing from the side, trying to go in onto Bulldog. Can they take this man down? He's got the guard out. Ain't going to help you against the Sunray. Bad by chance to Loader to turn around. Looking to go in onto DJ. Now heads back. They keep Bulldog alive with the heal. And Loader takes down that kill, and that is the kill that they needed. Bringing down mid one. Huge amount of money going into the pocket of the Lifestealer.
Only 800? Jeez.
Because the, I don't know.
I thought he'd be... You give way more gold.
Still, I don't know why. I was like talking because I assumed Fnatic wasn't going to fight that one.
Yeah.
Because they don't have Chronosphere. Why would they? They don't have Chronosphere.
They
don't
have Supernova. That was a little awkward. I guess at least, yeah. I mean, it was still 770 gold. I believe it wasn't that big because overall the team net worth is still pretty much bang on. Mm. And that does play a factor into the bounties. So because they're actually overall close in net worth, the difference isn't there. It doesn't actually give
it
as much.
Beyond godlike.
I know, it sounds flashy. Alliance, yeah, they'll feel like they've been sold a little bit cheap there with that kill, but nonetheless, obviously, great news for them that they take down Invoker. 16-14. I mean, Fnatic, we did talk about their lineup. We said that it needed to hit hard early on. To be level with Alliance's draft to 25 minutes in, that's bad news for Fnatic? Or they still got hope?
Extremely bad.
Yeah.
Very, very bad news.
Like, let's say they get, like, AC on Alliance and then, like, maybe a pipe to deal with Earth Spirit. Like, their damage is going to be so lacking, especially with the Crimson Guard already out on Bristleback.
Yeah.
Like, Drow Ranger has trouble doing damage, and she has trouble surviving. Imagine if she's just sitting there attacking away. I still don't think she can really kill that many people.
Look at this. They're trying to move out the base, Fnatic, but Alliance, they are ready to come in from the sidelines with this smoke. This could be a great way to catch them off guard from behind. Fnatic heading up to the high ground. Start to lead in. Can they get the lasso jumping in the hill bomb as well? They'll go on to Ohio. Ohio's gone. Can they take down the Supernova? They should be able to. Can they find it? One more touch. They have a second kill for Alliance. Loader backing up, and he's got the mech. The Crimson Guard healing him up from the sidelines. The team keeping the man alive. Mushi goes for the straight TP out. He will escape. Mid one's trying as well. Have they got anything to stop this? Yes, they have. Telekinesis bringing him up, taking him down. Alliance with a third on the side. Loader was also finishing off DJ. And at this point, to lose a team fight like this, this is all but crumbling for the side of Fnatic as Alliance look to storm ahead after fights like that, as we can see the swings continue.
They can wait for nighttime. I think Fnatic, yeah, they get crushed during daytime, but they just have to take fights during nighttime at this point. Because like their position was just so terrible. They think they have the high ground advantage, except Alliance see exactly where they are.
Then it's like some sort of like time aficionado. You're just so obsessed. You still have nighttime. Why are they taking it during nighttime? Nighttime's good.
It's important.
You really like nighttime.
Well, you're playing around. It's kind of like playing versus Night Stalker, right?
Yeah.
It's the opposite.
At this point, once you start losing fights, once the enemy team is able to put pressure on you and force fights on you, the Drone Ranger stat just falls apart, right? Because it's such a such an easy hero to exploit once you have the movement.
I think it would have been okay if they had more range heroes. If they have more range heroes, they can actually just split push, and they'll have multiple scaling cores. But their offlaner is a Faceless Void. He's just there to set up for the Invoker. He's not going to transition into a right-clicker at any point in this game.
Yeah.
So then you have a Drow Ranger who can just get focused by either Lifestealer or the Bristleback, or Lasso by the Batrider, Lifestealer, or Bristle, and there goes her damage. So they already have most of their factors controlled in the fight.
The funny thing is, just because it's the nature of a Drone Ranger lineup, if we hadn't seen some of the mistakes that we saw from Fnatic, like their attempt at contesting Ancients and something like that, we could have actually seen like a rather smooth game for them where they would be the ones pushing high ground by now. But
maybe one could go. He could go for the solo pickle, couldn't he? Maybe a bit wary that the Lifestealer might be inside us for. Maybe that's what was holding him off there.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
He's going to catch us for now, I think. Yeah,
I think he's still a bit timid about this, though, isn't he?
Yeah, you got to take chances mid-1.
You don't know what's inside this bat.
Yeah, you don't know what's inside the mystery box, but you kind of have to open it just because of the...
Yeah. He's got backup now. Mid-1's going to feel confident going in, surely.
Yeah.
Here we have it. Cold snap. S4 in trouble. Where's your bat? It's not coming out. Mid-1 knows it's a clean one. Bat's down 50 seconds for S4. So just playing carefully. I mean, you don't blame Fnatic, of course, at this point, to just play incredibly cautiously against Alliance's lineup, because we've seen them go for these kind of kills, and Alliance pretty much every other time has been there to counter it.
It's nighttime.
As you said, Ben, the kills start going the way of Fnatic as the sun sets.
Ben is all hot and bothered now.
And here we have it. During this nighttime phase into Roche, what are you going to do if you're Alliance? You don't have any bat for 20 seconds. Alliance.
You can recall him into the fight, so it's not as.
I mean, they're not going there at all. I guess, do they just sack it? They just, or do you think they're not aware that Fnatic are going for this?
It's nighttime, dude.
Right.
It's nighttime. That's all the answer you ever need, Owen.
I mean, it's just ever since the night has fallen, it's been plus to plus for Fnatic. Kill, Roshan, Aegis. I mean, in all seriousness, if you're Alliance, do you just say, all right, there's no point trying to do anything during the nighttime?
There really
just
isn't.
Wait. No.
Because Fnatic have, like, this five-minute window to bring the game back into their hands.
Yeah.
I think they can gank with the Batrider, but he could have gone for the BOT build, which would have, I think, put more pressure on Fnatic during nighttime. You have an FS bomb with the global presence, and then if he's out somewhere weird, you just recall him back. So I think they could have gone down that avenue if they wanted to keep up the pressure in nighttime as same as daytime, but instead they're going for BKB just to just flat out win team fights, no matter whether or not it's daytime or nighttime, and not going for the pickoff, which is fine.
So I think if you're Alliance, you give up this tier 2, it doesn't matter. You force Fnatic to try and go high ground.
I think Bristle alone would just be enough to stop it.
Yeah, exactly. And once you stop the Drone Ranger push, then what's the point of that lineup?
Go late scale game. Into late game with Ags and Mjolnir. Let's see it, Mushi. With a refresher on Void.
Out of the 10 players in this game, Ben, do you think Mushi's going to be the one to carry it to victory?
It looks like he's trying to right now. Look at him whomping away in the tower.
He's certainly giving it a good shot here. We'll see what Alliance can do to stop it. Okay.
If only it made laser sounds.
See if they get jumping. Fnatic playing it smart. They don't want to hang.
They could all in right now.
Well, Fnatic, let's go.
It's nighttime.
I think they should.
It's nighttime.
I legitimately think they should have backed, gone for a smoke play in this area.
This is like the point in the game where you might regret not pushing high ground. Or
you're either going to lose slow or you're going to lose fast.
Yeah.
At this point, right?
I would say so. That's kind of like, if we lose this fight, we'll probably lose the game. But I guess they don't feel that desperate yet, which is kind of reasonable. There's always more night times.
And they have Invoker. And Invoker is, like, Invoker is actually pretty, okay, he's going Lincoln's. I mean, that's a good item pickup. I just thought maybe they were going to be waiting on Ags in level 22.
That's a long time.
That is a long time, Ben. But that is your next. That's like the next peak for Fnatic.
Okay.
Right? It's not a very big one. But
convincingly.
What? Yeah. It's at 36 minutes, dude.
Huh?
That's next nighttime.
That's
nighttime's nearly over.
That's true.
Fnatic, they're trying to make the most of the last few minutes of the moon, and they have found Loader. Loader in trouble. Can they keep him alive, Alliance? There. Yeah, they will indeed. Telekinesis is on about DJ and the heels on the high ground.
Good work, EGM. Kick Loader back to safety.
Loader equals kicked. People will love that. I love that one. 17-17 they're now, Fnatic. This could be their downfall, Ben. They're trying to go aggressive by the looks of it, and
the
sun is
out.
The sun is out.
I don't know.
Well, they could have just done it like 3 minutes ago.
They could have done it during nighttime.
And the bottom T3 is much easier to push. It's already at like 200 HP. Eh? I don't know. Teach their own.
Let's see what they do here. They come in for a bit of a tickle, but Alliance, they'll shove them back out.
And now the Aegis is going to expire in like a minute and a half, so their timeline is slowly shrinking, maybe waiting for the Lincolns on the Invoker.
I'll take that. Lincolns, it's actually the mana drain that really locks him down. Mana leak, rather, from Ake. That hurts the Quaswex Invoker a lot because he's so mobile.
He could just time it, Radiant's drain all his mana before the EMP hits. Attack. Easy. Not easy.
Drain.
Not easy.
What?
What?
Drain. Coddles mana with EMP?
No.
He drains his own intentionally and then gets the mana back from the EMP.
Easy.
So he's like, I don't give a damn about your mana leak,
Just right. Keep running around, dude.
Yeah.
All right.
I just thought they won't find anything with this smoke alone.
Next level strats.
Trying to come into the jungle. They're still got the bands back with the lifesteal in. Oh, Fnatic coming along here. There's no vision from themselves out in their own jungle. And what am I?
Whoa, EGM.
Hey, sliding in and zapping away.
They could have just waited like
Fnatic
want to
fight this.
Yeah, that would have been a one team fight instantly if you just waited.
Can they take a daytime fight, Ben?
Yes, with Ake right there and when there's smoke, yes. With EGM right there, maybe not.
What if they walk the wrong way? Oh, no, they don't. They know. They're coming in. They're choosing the right angle. They want to go, right round from the back.
Chronosphere.
They don't have that much time, though. The Aegis is about to expire in 20.
Go. Go.
There we go, Jono! Chrono misses! Oh, that's still funny. Yeah, but Lode's already killed off the Phoenix, and he's now turned towards Mushi. Mushi's down as well. But he just will survive just long enough to keep him here for the second time round. Lode getting beat down. The bash is coming through. Lode in a bit of trouble. Mushi finds the positioning with a blink. They will find themselves a second now on Test 4. Three down onto Alliance. Ake is all alone. The old man on his horse. Bulldog's trying to come in to save it, but four dead on Alliance. The blast through will take down Ohio, but they're looking to team wipe this one on Fnatic. They've certainly done it this time round. Bulldog looking for a cheeky deny. It's not going to happen. Triple kill for mid one. And hey, who needs to hit Chronospheres, guys? You don't need it. And Ben, it's daytime. Any thoughts? What?
So firstly, a couple things went wrong for Alliance. They didn't check the drow. She had that blink, which caught them off guard after Aegis. And then she blinked up to the north, and Bristleback was on the south. So then she was able to just pew-pew on the lifesteal, and lifesteal died way too early on in the fight. The Chronosphere missed, but that's...
It was a zoning Chrono.
And in general, it was kind of pointless for, I think, Alliance to be in that kind of position.
They could have just waited out the Aegis.
Yeah, just wait out
the Aegis. Yeah, well, as you said, Ben, counting down, it's very close.
It was like 20 seconds away.
Just imagine the Chronosphere goes down and Dro Ranger doesn't end up dying as quickly and ends up dying a little bit later in the fight when Aegis is gone.
Oh, hello, AGM.
Maybe another scenario where Fnatic's mess up actually gets
and mid one's owning.
Yeah, easy kills here for the Invoker. 15-6.
I don't know if it's going to be enough. That was a big fight for them, though.
It really was. I mean, look at Mush's position now in terms of net worth. He's 18k on the Drow range. He's clear to ahead of.
Yeah, he's carrying, man. Who doubted his carry?
He's doing great this game, Mushi. He's having a fantastic time. It really, really is, and it looks like, that's going to be, Butterfly now complete as well for Mushi. So, the damage output bonus is going to be certainly sizable for mid one on his Invoker. I mean, he's already getting a plus 76. It's going to be even more now with that completed Butterfly on its way.
I think Bristle's job should be to stick on Drow, like, almost the entire
time. Make sure the aura's gone for mid one. Yeah.
Yes, and so she can't attack.
Yeah.
Like, she has to run at some point.
Yeah, and it gets harder and harder for her as you get more nasal goos on her.
But he has a lot of damage on Drow Ranger.
He really, really does.
Is he sitting at a good range as 360? That's incredible amounts.
It's almost time for you to actually have a Blink Dagger on Lifestealer, actually. We've seen that item a lot of times, just because it's so important for you to stick on heroes.
So who do you guys think is going to win at this point?
Oh, that's a hard call.
I think Alliance will still pull it out.
I don't know. I think if Alliance, one more mess up like that, Fnatic take a good fight with kind of the Drow or the Alacrity, they are ripping through your base. If Ohio hits a good Chronosphere as well into a Supernova, I think Fnatic are feeling comfortable. I mean, Loda, he's felt forced to go for the BKB as well, so his damage kind of potential is going to be held on pause for a bit.
The initiation advantage is to the favor of Alliance, though, when Fnatic try and push high ground. And that's the big difference between that bottom lane fight is in a way because of the Blink Dagger.
At this point, doesn't it seem that Fnatic's scaling better just because they're getting a lot more farm on the Drow Ranger and the Invoker than we expected?
Yeah, they kind of are.
Oh, Bulldog. They've spotted him out here.
He's really
good. He got a Blink Dagger on Bulldog.
Bristleback.
Wow. I like that, actually.
Hey, look at this. Ohio from the back lines. He's caught out to with the Chronosphere. What can they do with this? Fnatic Supernova following through for the high ground. Admiral Bulldog turning towards his attention, trying to take down the Sun. The Xylan Mushi clipping through Bulldog. Bulldog down to half health for this stage. Loda pots the BKB. Trying to go for Ohio. Has to back up now as it wears out. DJ rolls in with a three-man magnetize. EGM being pressured back. Alliance, they've got a retreat out of this one. It looks like they're the ones in trouble. Loda, he's been jumped on. He should get taken down. And indeed, they'll fly through. They'll take it. Ake to fall as well. EGM, he's gone. Alliance losing three. No buybacks available. And I think that's the mess up I was talking about, guys. You mess up like that, Fnatic, they're going to rip through your base.
So, yeah, like I said, I think Alliance is going to lose this game. So, sucks for them.
I mean, look.
It's nighttime.
It is nighttime, Ben. It is. We can't take that fact away from you. You're not wrong.
God damn it, Ben. Yeah, that was, again, the initiation came in from Fnatic as opposed to...
That was a good chrono.
Good chrono from Ohio, yeah. Yeah, that time.
Finally got it. And there was a lot of, like, the team didn't act as one there. There was many situations where, like, Bulldog backed away from the egg, then Loda and the rest of the team charged forward with their BKBs into the exploding egg.
Oh, yeah, that was super awkward.
Yeah.
Fnatic, I mean, just like that, of course. Two sets of racks taken away from the side of Alliance. I need to come back and hit with something incredibly hard.
If they don't protect the Sages, I think they just straight lose.
Yeah.
So, Fnatic,
run at them, Alliance.
Bulldog's got the memo. He's the lone man coming over at this point.
Oh, God.
Can he go for the blink play? Oh, he's trying. Oh, he's blinked straight in, Bulldog. God. He's tried for it. He will actually saved here by the kick. But at the least, it just obviously means for Fnatic, they do get away with taking Roshan, getting the Aegis. The MP's down. Nice Chrono from Ahio. Catching them all.
Oh, my God.
They're coming from the sidelines. Ahio doing it for the team this time around. S4 to fall as well. Luna's gone. Alliance crumbling to the power of Fnatic. GG. And we will be going to a game three. Fnatic, they're turning up. Game one, a little bit of a shoddy performance, but game two, they're just playing a lot better. And they did it with the Drow draft 39 minutes into the game.
Mushi played a lot better than last game.
Yes. Yeah. Firstly.
Mushi's performance.
Well, not in the beginning. Not in the beginning.
Not in the beginning, but...
He ramped up. He did really well with the Blink Dagger pickup, I think, was very smart on him. We were talking about, like, do you get Force Staff? Do you get Shadow Blade? The Blink Dagger was, I mean, especially with the Aegis and the way it happened in that fight, was perfect for him. And I don't know. I think everything kind of worked out for Fnatic. Alliance
Yeah.
just lost, like, that one team fight, and then it just kind of, like, kept tumbling and tumbling.